Hey guys, my name is Kyla, and this is my YouTube channel. Yes, it's my first video, and for my first video, I wanted to do a question and answer so you guys can learn more about me and get a better. This is gonna be so hard. All right, let's do that again. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Kyla, and this is my first video. And for my first video, I wanted to do a question and answer so you guys can learn a little bit more about me as a person. So let's get into it. So like I said before, my name is Kyla Charles, and my name is Kyla, not Kayla. All right, that's kind of one of my big pet peeves when people call me Kayla, because it's literally spelled or pronounced how it's spelled. K-A-I is Kai, L-A is La, Kyla. Say it with me. So, yes, my name is Kyla Charles, and I'm 21 years old. So, question number one, where are you from? So, I'm from PG County, Maryland. Yes, I'm from the DMV, the Murderland, baby. But, yeah, I'm from PG County, born and raised. I go to University of Maryland, so I've been here all my life. But my parents are from the Caribbean. They're immigrants, if you want to say. So my dad is from Trinidad and Tobago. My mom is from Antigua and Barbuda. So I am a Trini and Antiguan gal. Yes, I love being Caribbean. I love the culture. I love the food. I love everything about it. I love going back home and seeing my family who still live there. And so, yeah, I like the fact that I'm not just an American, Caribbean American, and I just tell people I'm Caribbean. Okay, so describe yourself in one word. So, if I would describe myself in one word, I would say unique, to be honest. I don't think you'll ever meet a person like me. I think, personally, everybody loves me. My name means lovable, that's what my mom told me, and I feel like I vibe with a lot of different type of people. And I have so many different vibes. Like, I can be chill, calm, but at the same time, I can be the life of the party. I could be lit. And yeah, I'm very independent. I can do so many things by myself and get a lot of things about myself. I can be in my room and have a lot of fun by myself. But at the same time, I love hanging out with my friends, love hanging out with my family, and I love having a good time. So, question number three, when did you start playing basketball? So if you guys didn't know, I played basketball at the University of Maryland. I started playing basketball in the fifth grade. I tried out for my middle school team because my siblings played, and I kind of wanted to follow in their footsteps. And I wasn't good at all because obviously that was the first time I played, and I didn't score my first basket until the last game of the season, literally like the fourth quarter. And like, something kind of ignited when I saw the ball go through the hoop, and I kind of developed a passion for it. And after that, I just decided to like perfect my craft and, you know, wanted to work hard because I wanted to play at the highest level possible. Question number four, who do you model your game after? Wow, this is so crazy. My favorite player ever to play the game, the GOAT, number one player to me, is Kobe Bryant. And that's just so crazy. Because I tried to record this video last week and I didn't like it, so I redid it and I redid it today. And it's just so crazy because he just passed away yesterday. And I love Kobe Bryant. I had dreams of meeting him one day and it was about to come true. I mean, I always had a goal to go to the WNBA and he always comes to games. So I was like, you know, one day when I'm playing the league, like, I'm going to meet him, because he's been an advocate in the last couple years for women's basketball. And I fell in love with his mentality, his game, the way he approaches everything in life. And I really try to like model my game after him and just learn a lot of stuff, especially the mental aspects of the game that he really focused on. And it's just so crazy that he died. I never ever thought I would ever like hear that news about Kobe Bryant, but rest in peace. He's the GOAT. He is my favorite player ever in the world. Will always be, and his legacy will live on. Like, legends never die. Heroes come and go, but legends never die, and he's definitely a legend. Alright, so question number five, which is my number. Why Maryland, and what other schools did you consider? So, if we're being 100% I did not want to come to Maryland. No shade to the University of Maryland. Great, like one of the best, not one of the best, is the best university in the world. Go Terps. But I wanted to venture out. Like I said, I've been here all my life and I wanted to have an experience. You know, I wanted to have a college experience in a different place. When I started my recruitment process, my coach, Coach Brenda Fries, was great. She would call me personally every week just to check up on me. And I'm local, so she would come to a lot of my high school games. The coaches would check on me, even the players. And when I came to like take visits or come to camp, like I just felt so welcome. The players were amazing, my teammates were amazing, the coaches were amazing. So I just felt really comfortable. And so that's kind of why I stayed home. Not necessarily because Maryland was 15 minutes down the road, but just how the coaches made me feel, and the team made me feel welcome, like a family away from home. And turns out it's probably one of the best decisions I've ever made. I get to see my family whenever, but at the same time, I get to, you know, be on my own. I have my own apartment on campus, so then I can just have the best of both worlds where I can, you know, need that space if I want to, but at the same time, I can go home for a good cooked meal. And when I need gas, I call my dad up like, hey, can you meet me at Costco? And he gives me a full tank. So I love the fact that I stayed home. And yeah, I am so grateful to have the opportunity to play at Maryland and be a hometown hero, essentially. I love representing my state. I love seeing my family in the stands every single game. And yeah, I love it here. Okay. Question number 6, what are you majoring in? So I am currently getting my degree in communications. I'm a senior, so I only have one semester left and it started today. And it's real chill, guys. I got one class. That's sign language, two, and it's 2 times a week, 1 hour and 15 minutes. And yeah, I'm big chilling, but I work hard for this because as basketball players, we are in school all year round. So I'm glad that my last semester, I get to kind of chill and just enjoy the last couple months that I have here. So yeah, I'm in communications. After my basketball career, I want to go into sports broadcasting or, you know, commentating. And I think communications, because I switched my major late, was the best route that I could take. And I think it's really relevant to the type of personality that I have. I'm very outgoing, well-spoken. Like I said, I appeal to a lot of people. And so I kind of want to do sports broadcasting. And that's kind of why I started a YouTube page too, just to get practice in. And yeah, so you guys will be seeing me on your TV in a couple of years on ESPN, you know, commentating games or maybe even having my own talk show. What's your channel going to be about? So my channel is going to be about everything, essentially. I'm really into fashion, I'm into beauty, I'm into sports. I'm into a lot of things and I kind of want to showcase that through my channel. So we might have fashion videos, like fits, beauty videos, makeup, hair, vlogs, because I play basketball. So you guys can, I want to do like day in the lives of like a student athlete. I want to do, you know, road trips, like showcase a road trip and just show you guys a little bit about my life. And this is going to be a great channel. And I really want you guys to stick with me and support me throughout the whole way, because with you guys, it will happen. I need you guys to make it happen. So yeah, that's what my channel is going to be about. Basically everything. What inspires you? So my family, hands down, definitely inspires me. Like I said, my parents are from the Caribbean and they came over to the U.S. in college. And just to see where they've come from and where they are now and how hard they've worked in between, it's truly inspirational. My parents have done all they can to give me and my siblings the life that we've always wanted. And I just want to be able to give them a fraction of that when I get older. And I just want to make them proud. So what's the hardest thing about being a college athlete? I would say balancing all the different demands that comes with it. And being a student athlete, you're there for your sport as well as school. So you have to balance practice, games, study hall, team meetings, recovery, all of that on top of school, you know, schoolwork, just what comes with college, having a social life. And so balancing all those aspects, I think, is the hardest thing. And this leads into the next question. And it's like, how do you find that balance? And That's basically time management. You gotta make sure that you put your priorities first, make sure that you're getting your work done so later you can go to a school event, or you are making sure that you maybe wake up early to work out, get your extra work in so that later you can hang out with your friends. So it's just time management is like the most important thing of balancing all of these different aspects. Any advice to college athletes? I would just say be present, enjoy every moment like it's your last, because you only get 4 years in college and those 4 years go by so fast. I know you guys probably heard it from people like, yeah, those 4 years go by quickly, and you will never know until you're actually, you know, in your 4 years. And I cannot believe I am about to graduate in a couple months in May. It feels like yesterday I just got to the campus and I was just starting summer school with my first college class, and I was, you know, nervous being a freshman, but now I'm a senior, and it literally went by like this. Like, it didn't even feel like 4 years. Like, even though I remember every single moment, every single year, every single day, it just went by so fast, like a blink of the eye. And you only get one college experience. This is gonna be the best 4 years of your life. So you just gotta make sure you enjoy the moments. Did you enjoy your time at UMD? I definitely enjoyed my time at UMD. I love my university. I've had so many memories that I will never forget, that I made with my teammates, past and present, with friends that I've known before I got here. And I'm honestly glad that I stayed here in Maryland. I've definitely enjoyed my time. I can remember so many laughs and memories and events and parties that me and my teammates made memories that will last a lifetime. And I'm so glad I came here. How do you feel about translating to the WNBA after your senior year is over? I am absolutely ecstatic. It's always been a dream to play at the highest level, and the WNBA is the highest level here in America, and I'm so excited because I can literally see my dreams in reach. I've always dreamed as a little girl to play in the WNBA, and I've worked my hardest, still working my hardest every day. I'm trying to perfect my craft, but I've, you know, try to put myself in the best position possible to get there. And if I keep doing what I'm doing and keep working hard and having faith in the Lord, I should be getting there in the next couple months. And I'm so excited because I get to see all these players that I've idolized, that I've watched as a young girl growing up, and I'm gonna get to play against them or play with them and learn from them and just, you know, like I said, enjoy the moment of, you know, doing what I love. And yeah, I'm so excited. I'm so excited. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed and got to learn a little bit more about me as a person. Thank you for tuning in and watching. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And make sure to turn the notifications on so you can get notified when I post new videos. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye.